we will show you how to correctly install sliding doors into an aisle between racks. We will need 3mm and 4mm hex keys, open-end wrenches, 1 8mm and 2 13mm wrenches, wire cutters, and groove joint pliers. Check that the distance between opposing racks is 120 centimeters or 180 centimeters. Take a column and place it next to the rack. For 120 centimeters aisle width, mount the column at these 3 points onto the rack. For 180 centimeters aisle, mount the column to the rack at these 3 points instead. Now, we'll install the doors for a 120 centimeters aisle. Mount the column to the rack column on both sides using M5 bolts and nuts. Do not tighten the bolts fully. Place 2 pairs of M5 screws into the upper section of the columns. Take the main connecting bar and fit it between the columns onto the screws. Tighten the screws. Also tighten the bolts anchoring the columns to the racks. Take the skirting bars and mount them onto the columns on both sides using M5 screws. Fasten the door rail using black countersunk M5 bolts, washers, and nuts at 8 points in total. Mount holders onto the top edge of the door using M5 screws. Mount 2 holders onto each door leaf and mount rollers onto them. Mount belt holders for dual synchronization into the center of each leaf. Rotate the holder on the left leaf by 180 degrees. Fit the coupler into the holder on the right leaf and fix it in place. Thread the belt through the coupler and secure it with pins. The smooth side of the belt faces to the outside. The other coupler will be fitted in the next step. Insert inner stops into the rail and fit a locking piece onto one of them. Slide the stops to the center of the rail. Slide the door into the rail and insert the outer stop, including a pulley for the belt. When fitting the door in place, make sure the bottom part of the door fits onto the guide rails on the column. Set the door leaves at the same height using the nuts at the top. Check that the brush at the bottom of the door fits to the ground evenly. The gap between the door leaves should also be even. Also, check that the door does not deviate inside or out. You can correct deviations by adjusting the roller holder. Retighten both nuts to fix them in place after you're done. Thread the belt through the other coupler. Wind it around the pulley to the inside. Cut off the belt at the midway point of the coupler holder. Fit the coupler into the holder and secure it with a pin. Close the door to measure out the other end of the belt. Thread the belt to the other side through the pulley to the coupler holder. Make sure the belt isn't twisted. Cut off the belt at the midway point of the holder. Now, move the outer stop a bit towards the center. Fasten the belt and the coupler and secure the coupler with a pin. Fit the coupler onto its holder and fix it in place. Tension the belt by moving the stop with the pulley to the edge again. Test the functioning of the door belt. When opening one leaf, the other must open simultaneously. Fit the side support covers with L-shaped holders and fasten them with M5 screws. Attach the rail to the covers. Use M5 screws to fasten a covering piece to the back. mount a central front cover using M5 screws. Mount a bottom cover onto the underside of the crossbeam using M5 screws. Set the stops on the edges and in the center to prevent the door leaves from making hard impacts.